The Team Lally Show was previously recorded.
It's time to enter the world of real estate in Oahu with Hawaii's only true real estate radio show, the Team Lally Real Estate Show. Grab a pen and get ready to take notes. For the next full hour, Hawaii's premier real estate leader, Adrienne Lally, and Attilio Leonardi will bring you the latest in real estate news and real-world strategies on how they can guarantee to sell your home at a price and deadline you agree to, or they'll buy it. Now, here are your hosts, Adrienne and Attilio.
Welcome to the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the Guaranteed Sold program, or we'll buy it. If you have any questions, just give us a call at 799-9596 or check us out online at teamlally.com.
Well, hey, everybody, this is Attilio, and this is the part of the show where we talk about art. Not like kind of art that you see in like museums or paintings or sculptures or things like that, but it's an acronym, stands for Attilio's Random Thoughts. This is the what I want to talk about today. It was part of our reading from the book that we're reading, Dare to Lead by Dr. Brene Brown. And what were your key takeaways that you remembered from today's reading, Adrienne?
Well, I think more along the lines of trust and trusting yourself and knowing yourself, loving yourself in order to trust others.
Yeah. So imagine that everybody's walking around with an invisible marble jar, a jar full of marbles in their hand. Mm-hmm. And the good things that we do for them, blink, put a marble in that jar for them. And those little things are what builds trust. It's not big things like, oh, wow, I came and bailed you out of that jail in Tijuana and brought you back to the U.S. and sobered you up. No, it's not like big things like that. It's little things. And actually, one of the things that was like number one was just, I don't know if it's a big thing. I don't think it's that big of a thing, but showing up at funerals.
Oh, yes.
Showing up at funerals.
Showing up at the funeral. Yeah.
And so if you go around in life putting marbles in people's jars, and especially people that are your loved ones, your kids, your significant others, people you work with, people in your church organization, any organization, your customers, your clients, if you're putting marbles in their jar, that's what builds the foundation for trust.
So put some marbles in others' jars, and then yours will also be filled as well.
And, right? And, mm-hmm. One of the ways that we can, and you think about it, you think it's about putting a marble in a jar. So you think of what? Giving or taking?
Giving.
So you're thinking about giving, but there is something that you do in the taking side of that that builds trust. And the taking part of that is the part that a lot of human beings have challenges with because the ego gets in the way, the judgment gets in the way. It's asking for
help.
Asking for help.
And I also wanted to comment on the giving side,
yeah,
in the PSI community, which actually I just staffed my first PSI basic.
This what does PSI weekend. Stand for?
Personal Success Institute.
Personal Success Institute.
So one of their, mottos is givers gain.
Givers gain.
Givers gain.
Yeah. So PSI, folks, one of my things that I go through in my life, rules of thumb, I don't know, it's rule, Tilio's rule number 98. Is if there's something that could be good in your life or make a change in your life, and you hear it from three different sources, that's the universe communicating that you need to do that, pay attention to that, sign up for that, mm-hmm. Go do that.
So you hear it. You heard it from us.
So if two of your friends are saying, "Hey, brah, you need to go PSI." Hopefully we're number three.
That's right.
If we're number two, then I'm sure number three is going to come along.
The other thing, we support this kind of growth and training development so
yes.
much that it's part of being on our team.
It's part of our culture. And if our you're culture. On our team, mm-hmm. We don't require that you do it. But if you want to continue to upward trajectory or
and to grow on
growth
the team,
with our team,
yep,
we highly recommend it.
That's what you got to do.
Okay. Speaking of someone that's growth-oriented and always learning. and always improving and an expert in a particular field. Which field, Adrian?
She is an expert at reverse mortgages. Yes, we have Wendy Oshiro here to give us the reverse mortgage tip of the week.
Yes.
Wendy, are you there?
Aloha. Yes. And my tip of the week is for people who are nearing retirement, and it's to help them create a better retirement for tomorrow. And basically, you know, a lot of us go into retirement with a mortgage balance. And one thing that they don't know about is that they could actually refinance their existing balance into a reverse mortgage mm-hmm. in order to continue to make payments back into what's called a growing line of credit. So, you know, most people think about making a mortgage payment, maybe an extra mortgage payment in order to bring their loan balance down and pay it off within maybe before their 30-year term is up. But with a reverse mortgage, if you make payments back to it, even though you don't have to make payments, what happens to it is it can become available to you in a line of credit. But that line of credit is growing every month. It's basically just how it's the way that the loan is structured, so that later on in the future, if you need to access those funds again, you may, and you can use it for whatever purpose you wish in retirement. So that's a lot of things that something that people don't really aren't aware of.
It's a really outside of the box way of using the strategy of the reverse mortgage.
Of the reverse mortgage
with a line of credit,
right?
Who would have thought? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, Wendy, we know in marketing, here's the deal. You got 3 seconds to grab somebody's attention, and then how you keep the attention is with a story. So tell us the story. I always like this story. Tell us the story of why you got into reverse mortgages, because I think that story impacts people.
Oh, I got into it because I made a mistake with my own parents.
Yeah.
As their, you know, successor trustee, as their power of attorney, I had a lot of responsibility in taking care of them when they lost their independence. But nobody teaches you how to do it. And so, you know, I didn't think about their quality of life when I made certain decisions about where they should live. And because they lost their independence, I thought they should live in a care home.
Yeah.
And that would be the best place for them. But that was, you know, if I had known better, if I had to do it over again today, I wouldn't have done that. I actually would have considered a reverse mortgage, which could have kept them in their home. You know, but yeah, but like a lot of people, I just thought that it was a bad thing. But if you ask me why, I couldn't really tell you.
Yeah,
I didn't know enough about it to be able to make a decision.
You know, that's what they say. I just read a book called The Psychology of Money. We make 80% of our financial decisions based on 0.1% of what we know. So you're right. You're not the only one. There are tons of people that are making all kind of huge decisions one way or the other based on very little information.
And the information is usually not even accurate.
And your pendulum swings so far the other way that you not only researched it, you got involved with it because you realized what? Yep. What about reverse mortgages can help with these people?
Yeah. So, yeah. And, you know, I'm a teacher, right?
Yeah.
I've been a classroom teacher for 16 years, and I did the very thing that I didn't do, the very thing that I teach my students to do, which is to explore all their options, right, before they decide on a solution.
Mm-hmm.
So I actually, after I sold my parents' house, that's when I researched reverse mortgages. But I discovered that it could have been a really good option for them to satisfy their desire to stay at home.
Yeah.
And it was too late. So now I'm on a mission, right, to educate people about this misunderstood loan product and just let people know that really you should, if you're taking care of your parents, you really should consider all options.
Yeah.
And yeah, the reverse mortgage might not work out, but at least you know it doesn't and you know why, you know. So
as opposed to guessing.
Just here to educate people.
Yeah.
So, so you educate not only the consumers, but I know that you do continuing education classes for us realtors so that we understand and can, you know, bring that to our clients' attention as an alternative.
Oh.
Right. Education is so important, especially for professionals. So we do have CE classes for financial advisors as well.
Mm-hmm.
And it's, Yeah, we're all in it together, right? Trying to help our ohana, which includes our kupuna, to live here.
Well,
for
their
whole lifetime, hopefully, and it's getting. Yeah,
I think for the kids out there with the parents, for the realtors out there in this profession, it's important to know this because I know that we've had this. This is coming our way. It's a silver tsunami.
That's right.
Silver tsunami. Randy, have you heard that term?
You gotta be ready for that.
Silver tsunami?
I have.
Yeah, it's like when you go Black Friday and all the retirees run you over to go get the the TV on. No. That's not the silver. The silver tsunami is the aging. Mm-hmm. Is the aging population in Hawaii. Per capita, we have an older population, older demographic than a lot of the states in the United States. So I think more per capita over 65 and over 85 than in the mainland. You know why? Because Hawaii is like, it's a nice place to grow old.
It is.
Would you agree?
And I think more people live longer here because they're happier. It's the aloha spirit.
It's the aloha spirit.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
It's making people live long.
Mm-hmm. And use their reverse mortgage tool because it's there as a resource.
Yep. Wendy. And,
but learn about it first.
That's yes.
Right. Sure. Call me to learn about it.
before we send you on your way and we'll you know, after you disconnect, we'll give them the contact. What would you say is the number one myth or misunderstanding that people have about it, and what will be the number one benefit?
The number one misconception is the bank is going to take title to the house when you do a reverse mortgage, and that's not true.
Yeah.
And the number one benefit, you know, I was just, I talk to a lot of my customers and check up on them, and so often I hear peace of mind. That's what they say the benefit is from the senior's perspective.
Mm-hmm.
So, I'll go with that, peace of mind. Knowing that you have funds available to help you live more comfortably in retirement.
Well, you know, I was listening to this podcast about, they said that a big, huge chunk of songs are made up of four chords. And the producer was like, well, why don't people like, you know, get all upset with that? That a lot of the songs have these same four chords in them and just different timing. He said, because human nature, we like things that are the same, you know, that are similar. We don't. And it provides a comfort. And I think the human nature that the reverse mortgage appeals to or what it's helping is that as you grow old, especially if you lived in the house, you raised your children, you've seen the kids go off to college, the kids come back with the grandkids get raised up and go off and maybe even great grandkids, and it becomes a gathering place. Who wouldn't want to age in place with all those memories as opposed to... where I'm going to go, whereas they're going to have like, it's going to be like, they're going to do snowboarding, going to have poker night, going to have sexy attendants. That's where I'm going to go. Even with all of that, I'm joking. I would rather age in place, even with all of that.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you know, even joking aside, I'd rather stay in my home.
And studies show you're healthier when you're happier, right? So most people are happy in the place that they've been in for a long time. Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, thanks, Wendy.
Yes. Thank you, Wendy. Always excellent information that you share on the reverse mortgage process.
How can we get a hold of Wendy?
Okay. We can get a hold of Wendy if you just give her a call at 753-9819. Again, that's 753-9819. You can also go to our website under the resource tab and click on Experts We Trust. And Wendy is right there.
Yeah.
You can find out all about Wendy and her team there.
Next expert up we have is Dan from the Big Island. Hey, Dan, what you got for us this week?
Hey, guys, how are you?
We're doing great.
Well, everybody's asking the question, how long will the frenzy end? And the answer is, what do you tell them?
What do you tell them? You know what?
I thought you were going to give us the answer.
Well, here's what I'm going to tell them when the frenzy ends is when the water starts being chummed. Mm-hmm. And the water is being chummed by low inventory and low interest rates. So when that chum stops hitting the water.
I think it's mostly a low inventory issue.
Low inventory.
Yes, that is the issue.
The low inventory.
Low inventory.
Well,
we need more homes.
Well,
more homes.
I don't know what's going on the Big Island, but we had three months in a row of prices being record highs for single family, median price, and then this current month they went down. So I don't know. We have to probably wait another month or two to see if that pans out.
Condos are about the same. Condos are
flat.
Not so as extreme as the single family.
I don't know. What you telling them over there on the Big Island?
Well, I've been telling them fall.
Yeah.
And they always ask me why. And I give them a variety of factors. But I think one of the more interesting stories of the week is a survey that came out that said that 70% of people have told their employers that they would prefer to have some flexibility on their job and job location, meaning they would like a hybrid model of continuing to work from home and maybe, maybe coming into an office.
Yeah.
Which I think is not surprising. We probably could have predicted that. But on the flip side, 60% of employers say they don't want a hybrid model. They want you to come back to the office.
Yeah.
Right? And so now what's going to give? And I think that, you know, the short answer is the employer is going to win because it'll ultimately be, well, if you want your job,
it's over here.
You're going to come back to the office, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And so what I think a lot of people had these grand visions that they were going to be working from fill in the blank.
Yeah.
Hawaii, the lake house,
the beach,
wherever it may be.
Yeah.
For the rest of their lives. And now it's going to start to come to reality here soon that people are going to have to return back to the cities and back to the office buildings. And that's going to have a chilling effect on the real estate market. There's no two ways about it.
Yeah. No more people saying, oh, yeah, if I can work anywhere, I'm going to work in my house in Hawaii.
Mm-hmm.
Well, not if you got to commute back to Seattle or something for your job. So,
yeah, I was reading a blog of a high-powered trader on the New York Stock Exchange, and one of his ideas was, when the pandemic hit, was to get out of New York and get to Hawaii and start working from Hawaii.
Yeah.
But then when he realized about the six-hour time difference and the fact that he was getting up at 3 o'clock in the morning start the trading day, he thought, well, this isn't working out as well as I thought.
Yeah.
So he eventually left the island and went back to New York. So I'm just wondering, when you talk about economic factors slowing down the economy, like, for instance, many people, if you're my age, 50 or older, then you know the term stagnation, right? Stagnation is a term that was used during the Carter administration. And what it is it's a combination of stagnant job growth and inflation.
Mm-hmm.
So we haven't seen stagnation in a number of years until now. Now we have stagnation. We've got inflation with stagnant job growth. And some of these things are going to start to take effect and slow down this frenzy.
Yeah.
And your prediction is this fall.
This fall. And if
this
it doesn't
fall.
Happen, you said, I meant 2023 or 2022. But
I mean, it cannot remain this way forever.
It cannot.
Like, at some point, it needs to kind of calm down a bit.
Yeah, well, it's
correct.
It's like it's just, physics, you know. Everything that goes up must come down eventually.
Mm-hmm.
Or it's going to
take this as a factor. Like, how long would it take you as a buyer to be worn out on this process? Like, if you were in the buyer's situations, how long would it take for you to say, you know what, maybe I'll take a year off and let all this settle down? Because I'm already hearing that.
Yeah.
Well, I'm a pretty impatient person, so I'm so happy that I'm not a buyer in this market, because I think that I just don't have the patience for it.
It would take Adrian one offer, everybody else about 10, because they would hang in there. But, you know, you're right, Dan, because that's exactly when the market turns, is when the buyer says, I'm tapping out.
Yeah.
I'm tapping out. No more participating in acceleration clauses and all of that.
I had a conversation with a buyer who said, you know, I'm definitely not going to buy after I sell my property. I might just rent. I might just travel. I might just do whatever, because I don't want to buy at the peak of the market. And I said, so how long are you going to take off? She said, well, I probably won't buy anything for a year.
Yeah.
And then I said, well, how do you know the peak of the market isn't a year from now?
Yeah.
And she said, yeah. Well, that's a good point. She said, well, do you think it'll be this frenzy? I said, well, listen, just go back and look historically. Generally, as a rule, Hawaii real estate doesn't go negative there's only one time in the last 30 years that Hawaii real estate has gone negative, and that was during the crash.
Yeah.
But for the most part, Hawaii real estate is always and constantly appreciating. So, you know, do you want to buy now or do you want to buy next year when the appreciation is moderate, say 6%, say 7%, say 8%, whatever the case may be. It probably won't, the appreciation in a year probably won't rise by 14% again. But if it rises by 5%, well, then that's a pretty good deal if you buy right now, because a year from now, you just gained 5% appreciation.
Yeah. All good stuff.
Yes. So we will check back with you on how things are continuing to progress on the Big Islands.
And we won't, and we promise we're not going to wait till the fall.
We'll be checking back pretty frequently with you, Dan.
All right.
We want to know.
Thanks, Dan.
All right. Thanks, Dan. So that's Dan Palomino. He's there with the KW Big Island. And
you know what? If you have any needs for Kauai, Big Island, Maui, you know what the number you should call?
799-9596. We will connect you up.
All righty.
We got you.
Okay. So we want to share some more information, or we want to go to take them to a break?
I think it's time for a break.
Okay. Well, real quick, before we do go to a break, I just want to remind people, OahuDivorce.com. Mm-hmm. If you're an attorney out there and you want continuing law education, normally $55, go to our website. We've got a code. You punch it in. This month's CLE, the speaker is going to be talking about appraisal values, because we've just been talking about it. That is such a fast-moving target right now.
It is a hot topic.
As an attorney representing a client where you got real estate that needs to be sold, you want to make sure that you've gotten your values super dialed in. What better way to get knowledgeable about that and take care of a CLE than going to OahuDivorce.com, signing up for our monthly CLEs.
All right. On that note, we are going to take a break. Let's stay with us. When we come back, we'll be talking with Bradley Maruyama of Allstate Insurance. He's going to help us demystify all the confusing options and choices to insurance policies. Stay with us.
This is Scotty B from News Radio 830 KHVH. Well, Team Lally helping you make the most of this incredible opportunity. You know, the housing market has been just unbelievable. Low inventory, not many houses on the market, low interest rates. So if you are going to make a move right now, contact Team Lally. That's Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi of Team Lally Real Estate Group of Keller Williams, Honolulu. Their superior marketing, so successful, they're selling homes up to 65K over list. Rhoda decided it was a great time to sell her $750,000 investment property in Waikiki. Well, Adrian and Attilio's comprehensive marketing created a buzz, which resulted in multiple offers within 2 days, drove the price up $25,000 over asking. Rhoda's thrilled, obviously, with her profits. And they can make this happen for you. Call 799-9596. Or online, get the process started right now. Go to teamlally.com. That's team, L-A-L-L-Y.com.
Hi, I'm Barbara Corcoran. I hope every family will stay healthy and safe during these uncertain times. Our real estate market is experiencing many challenges every day. If you're planning to move or sell your home now, be sure to get the most current information from the best agent in your marketplace. In Honolulu, you should call Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi. You'll need an agent who is trusted in your community and understands your needs. Go online or call, and please stay safe.
Hello, Hawaii. It's Colin Cowherd. Things may have changed in the sports world, but the games must go on. Look, I invest in real estate all over America, and right now with the ultra-low interest rates everywhere, if you're serious about selling your home, you need to talk to my friends Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi of Team Lally, Real Estate Group of Keller Williams, Honolulu. Team Lally's incredible marketing with 3D tours and its huge database of buyers has continued to sell homes quickly with multiple offers over the asking price. Adrian and Attilio continue to spend tens of thousands per month on marketing to attract hundreds of buyers every month using a unique app that communicates daily with over 3 million luxury home buyers around the United States. Adrian and Antilio guarantee to sell your home at a price and deadline you agree to, or they'll buy it themselves. Give Adrian and Antilio a call at 799 800-998-9596 or online at teamlally.com. That's teamlally.com. And start packing.
The Team Lally Real Estate Show continues. Give it to me, I'm worth it.
Baby, I'm worth it. Welcome back, and thanks for listening to the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the Guaranteed Sold program, or we'll buy it. I'm Adrian.
And I'm Attilio.
And if you have any questions, just give us a call at 799-9596 or check us out online at teamlally.com.
Our guest today was born and raised in Hawaii. He earned his Bachelor of Business Administration at the University of Hawaii at Manoa.
Through the years, he's come to know many local families and developed many relationships, which he has used to better understand the needs of his customers.
With over 20 years of service to customers of Allstate Insurance, he is the owner of Maruyama and Associates, Allstate Insurance. Please welcome our guest, Bradley Maruyama. Hey, Bradley.
Are you there?
Hey, how's it going?
Hi.
Let's get ready to talk about insurance.
All right.
So you're always giving us tips every week or whenever we can get you on. So we'll go a little bit longer and go a little bit deeper.
Yeah.
With this, anything COVID related, I'm just curious regarding insurance.
COVID related, nothing's really changed. Our office has been open, and we're all in. So I know I went down to the Servco dealership yesterday, and he said, "It's so weird, Brad." I said, "Why? What's going on? What's weird about this COVID time?" He goes, "You know, a lot of the companies are closed, and they're working from home."
Yeah.
I said, "What about you guys?" He said, "No, we're in the office, and everyone comes. So we're physically in the office, and we're not routing our phone calls at all."
Gotcha.
We're still operating as if COVID never happened.
And you guys have been in the office for a while. I know that you kind of jumped in and created some safety protocols and had your team there together supporting each other and your clients.
Yeah, they had the option. Some people, most of them rather have come to work and be able to have access to all the brochures and their files instead of working from a laptop and bringing their phones home. So they actually preferred working in the office rather than at home by themselves.
Yeah. So let's talk about homeowners insurance, because it's a real estate show.
And that's important.
Talk about homeowners insurance. Anyway, we're going to talk about homeowners insurance. What do you think are the number one things that cause homeowners insurance to be costly? Or not more costly, but cost more than normal. What would be things that people need to pay attention to with their home purchase?
Well, let's when you're buying a home or you're purchasing a home, there's two components or two different types of policies that's needed in order to close, and it's homeowners and hurricane.
Yeah.
Now, the homeowners insurance is pretty standard. If there's a fire, wind damage, a broken appliance, theft, or vandalism. But we've been seeing that there's a big cost disparity with hurricane insurance. So things that you can look at if you're a first-time home buyer or a home buyer in general, single-wall construction versus double-wall construction could make a huge impact on the premium. So on average, a single-wall constructed home in East Honolulu could run you about $2,000 per year. A double-wall constructed home in East Honolulu could run you $800 to $900 per year. So you can see that the $1,000 disparity is where you're going to see a big cost savings or a big cost impact.
I think that's really important to know, especially if you're kind of tight on your pre-approval, right? As far as, you're maxing out that pre-approved price, and the next thing you know, the insurance is twice as the amount that you expected.
Yeah.
So at what point should the buyer come to see you to get these quotes?
Yeah, so the great people at Team Lally, they actually always, it could be from the very start when someone's just even looking at a property. So even before pursuing and going through the whole process, they'll send out an email or give me a call and say, "Hey, Brad, can you get us a close estimate of how much this property is going to cost at address blank and blank. And then from the address and the city and county information, we can get a pretty close estimate of how much they're going to be looking at paying.
Yeah, I remember.
Typically, I notice. I typically notice that a lot of your team members will get inquiries when they're in a flood zone or if it's a single wall constructed home, because they already kind of know that a single wall constructed home or a flood zone could impact the qualification of that home buyer buying or not buying a property.
In fact, we saw early with the insurance quote, one time our clients was at the hospital and they was getting one sonogram. And they're like, you know, our son over here, he's going to be born in about 8 months. And I think about 25 years from now, we're going to help him buy one house. What do you think the homeowner's insurance could be at that point? No. And then, yeah, there was Bradley. He was in the room. He was like, wow, he looked like a healthy boy and looks like insurance, you know, based on future calculations. No. Get it done early is the point. I'm being highly exaggerative and demonstrative, but get it done early. Can the cost of insurance have somebody not be able to get the home?
Absolutely. Yeah. And I mean, thankfully, we've got Bradley on our team to help problem solve. And I know that we've had several situations that he's been able to help our team members and clients work through scenarios that did not look so good right from the get-go.
Yes,
so.
And the single wall versus double wall, I mean, you can take a single wall home and have double wall construction put all throughout the home, right, to save on the insurance?
Yeah, that's absolutely correct.
Yeah.
And along with that, since we're on the double wall, single wall, we do have carriers. There's some homes that they have been renovated or extended in the last 5, 10, 15, 20 years. But if the Palomar, for an example, Palomar Hurricane Insurance, if the home is 66 2/3 double wall, and the other 33% is single wall, they'll classify the whole home as a double wall rating. So it's always good to, we can always send out a quote, but when we get the appraisal, we're going to see that maybe more than 66% is double wall. So sometimes we've been able to save some clients' money that way as well.
Yeah. It's good for hanging photos.
Does that make sense?
Yeah, and it's good for hanging pictures like that, because single wall, you hit the nail through the wall, and the kid's on the other side going, ow! With the double wall, you know, hit the kids. Because it's my dad did that with his house, and it came out really nice. Older home, and he put in the double wall construction.
And he's saving on insurance.
You can run electrical outlets more spaced out throughout the home, because then you're not having the conduit, and everything is all exposed. So it looks really nice when you do the molding, crown molding.
There's so many benefits.
Yeah. And then the kids, you know, when you're hanging the photos, they're not like, ow, the nail went through the wall.
So
what else?
I would say let's touch on the flood zone, because I think that's usually the most surprising situation that comes up when you're searching for a home. And what do you do? How do you navigate through that? Even if it's like a part of the home that's in the flood zone, and what are the solutions, Bradley?
Yeah,
so, you know, what's really, really important when you're selling or buying a home, the first thing that we always ask for when we're going to do a quote is there an elevation certificate done? And basically what an elevation certificate is, it's going to show how high this home is elevated above the base flood elevation or the water line or the water mark. So can we do a quote without an elevation certificate? Yes, we can. But it'll spit out a very general quote.
Mm-hmm.
So we always tell people, try to see if they can get an elevation certificate from the seller.
Now, who does these elevation certificates?
It's surveyors.
Surveyors.
Yeah. So the surveyor can provide.
Surveyors.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
So get that
the
done.
The cost is typically...
Yeah, how much does it cost?
$750 to about $1,200 per survey.
Okay.
But it's well worth it, especially if your elevation is above that level and you are paying like a third of what, you know, it is
now,
without, right?
We have a listing You know, a lot of times you got to get that not only in flood zones, but if you're oceanfront, right? Mm-hmm. The elevation certificate.
Yep.
When you're oceanfront.
Yep.
So here's an interesting one. We have an oceanfront listing right now. Real. This is real life stories here. 60 Minutes. Mike Wallace came out and did a... No, Mike Wallace didn't come out. But
let's talk about Naupaka.
Yeah, Naupaka Street. And so it was interesting. It's up on the Laie Point. And if you guys know, Laie Point is up on a cliff.
Mm-hmm.
But it's all oceanfront properties. But they're at least, if I had to guess, 10, 15 feet above the waterline. But you still got to get the elevation certificate because it's on the ocean. And
because it's in a flood zone, yep.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So just... I don't know if when tsunami, if when wave came that was that big, we all be in trouble because that would be on 40-foot wave.
Yeah.
But what else about insurance? What are some of the common misperceptions that people have or should be aware of now, as opposed to when those calamities happen?
Let's see here. Some of the things that have been coming up.
Yeah.
I talked about what's covered under a homeowner's policy. So yeah. It's fire, wind, sudden accidental pipe burst, vandalism, and theft. Now, a sudden and accidental pipe burst, this is where some people are mystified or they come upset. If there's a slow leaking pipe,
yes,
and you start to see mold or you see a watermark in your wall or ceiling and you don't fix it, what's going to happen? Mold and mildew is going to form.
Get worse.
So if there's a slow leaking pipe and we don't fix it, that's something that's excluded. Now, people, we will cover a sudden accidental water heater that bursts. We'll cover a toilet bowl that overflows, an ice maker that breaks because there's that copper wire in the back, and sometimes people pull out the fridge and yes. push it back in, and it punctures. Those are kinds of things that we cover. Overflowing washing machine. These are could be catastrophic and flood your whole house. With a slow leaking pipe in the back of your cupboard under your sink that slowly deteriorates your cabinets and forms mold and mildew, those are excluded.
Oh.
So, you know,
so you got to keep an eye on those things.
What about?
Correct.
What about your crazy uncle and he's seeing people in the walls? Is that covered?
I have
no. Not covered. Not a cover.
Not covered.
What if?
I see people in the walls.
What about an uninsured drunk driver who runs into a fire hydrant and then it floods your house?
Oh,
yeah.
Oh boy.
Well, you know, talk about the water. Yeah, talk about the water, how it comes in. Because you have these real short stories on mm-hmm. how to remember about how the water enters the home. Tell the people about that.
Okay, so I try to keep it as simple as possible.
Yeah.
The water never touches the ground. So the water enters through your window or the wind blows off the shingles and water enters through your roof and never touches the ground. That's going to be your homeowner's insurance that covers to fix your roof and your flooring or hurricane insurance.
Mm-hmm.
Now, once the water touches the ground and enters your home or business through the front door, that's when flood insurance comes in. Now,
gotcha.
In the fine print, they call it surface water. So surface mm-hmm. water would be water touches the ground, enters the front door. It could be a tsunami. It could be storm surge from a hurricane, or it could be from an overflowing fire hydrant that
bounces through the air
and comes into your front door. Yeah.
So
let's talk about that because Bradley showed up with the moment of truth and he helped us.
Yeah, get through that.
He helped us through that. And that's why we do our business with Bradley. Yeah. And his team.
You. And, you know, we call it the moment of truth.
Mm-hmm.
And what we mean by the moment of truth is that, you know, in case you, you're on one first date with somebody and you're asking them, do you have one good job? And they're going to lie to you. Bradley can come out with the moment of truth. This guy, he hasn't worked in 6 months. He's lying. No. That's not what I mean by the moment of truth. What do we mean by the moment of truth, Adrian?
That's like that moment that nobody ever wants, but when you have to use your insurance because
something happened.
Something unusual happened. And that's why you have insurance, is to cover these unusual situations. And Bradley is there to help you and hold your hand and walk you through it and make sure that, you know, you understand the process and will just help you get things done.
I know, because you call all the insurance guys and you're like, oh, my house will catch on fire. And you know what they say? Oh, who's this? Bradley's like, oh, hey, Mr. So-and-so. I know, because we personally have had you actively involved in insurance situations, and you're
a couple of times throughout our over a decade.
If you wore long sleeve shirts, like in the mainland, or like me, you would be rolling them up, but you get the golf shirt, and so you don't need to roll your sleeves up. But it's just imagine Bradley rolling up his sleeves and getting to work. He all the time.
He does.
How long have we been in sending you business?
Over a decade.
Over a decade, and
over 10 years.
And you know what? All my insurance, my rental, my investment property insurance, my house insurance, my car insurance, my surfboard insurance. No. All my insurance is through Bradley. So, folks, we're not just telling you, oh, you should use Bradley because he's with Allstate. It's personal experience.
Because he's awesome.
He's awesome. But Bradley, any final tips for our listeners? Homeowners insurance, car insurance.
Funny stories, success stories.
Yeah. Success stories.
Well, this is the most important one because, you know, we talk about the moment of truth. And when I have to roll up my sleeves for these claims and I got to present unfortunate news, a lot of times this unfortunate news comes up because myself or the client haven't reviewed the policy together. Yeah. So, you know, things change. People do extensions. Cost of construction increases. They may have done upgrades and haven't notified us. Or someone might have gotten married and had a wedding ring and now they didn't have it insured or added on to their home and now there's a theft and we can't cover it. So I think the experience is that if we sit down once a year and review and go over changes in your life or extension, this can help the moment of truth of the claims process. So when your house does burn down, there is enough coverage. If there is a theft, the ring is covered. If there is a hurricane, your beds can be replaced in your refrigerator and microwave because people don't realize, but I would say 75% of the homeowners here, when they're buying their first home or buying a property, they're going to get the cheapest amount of insurance that they can get in order to just suffice the loan. So, you know, review your policy. Make sure that if you have a single wall constructed home, that you have building codes coverage on your hurricane insurance, because if that house ever blows away, they're going to have to rebuild it double wall construction, which costs more. Yeah. So, you know, these things are important to review with your insurance agent. And if you don't feel comfortable reviewing it with your insurance agent, give me a call. This is where I'll do complimentary reviews and give you some tips to see where you could save or possibly there might be some gaps in your policy. So, doing a review can really make the moment of truth much more positive for both parties.
I have three sisters, so I can just say one of my sisters, and you won't know who. But she's like, her roof was leaking because it was re-roofing the thing, and it was raining. She called up her insurance agent to make a claim. The agent was like yelling at her. I'm like, give me this guy's phone number. Where does this guy live? I'm going to go visit him. I'm like, what are you yelling at your client because they want to make a claim? I said, it's time for you to get. But anyway, you know, that moment of truth, right? Everybody's, you know, I think our true character is not when the sun is shining. Our true character comes out when things aren't going well. And Bradley has proven his servant's mentality time and time again.
And I'm so glad that you have come on the show and you reminded me, Bradley, because I have made some nice little upgrades to my house recently. So I think me and you, we've got to sit down and update.
Review, make sure everything's covered.
Yes.
Covered. Okay.
Well, you know what's also interesting? I wanted to throw this out because there's so many people that listen to this show. But if you live on Kauai, recently, I've been seeing appraisals come back at $500 to $700 per square foot to rebuild.
Wow!
And so the construction costs out in Kauai is so high right now, and you know, typically here on Oahu, it'll go from $210 to about $250 for an average standard home. But in Kauai, even these average standard homes are going for $500 a foot. So, if you are out there, you should do a review because these contractors, when I talk to them, they're saying, the going rate now is about $500 a foot.
So make sure you got enough coverage because you don't want to be stuck in that gap, right?
That's nuts. You're going to be stuck in that gap.
One tent down at the beach, that's going to be the gap because you don't have enough insurance.
Or they just come move to Oahu.
Or you're going to have to be like, oh, you know what? Sorry, can I replace the house? I'm going to have to replace them with one yurt.
There you go.
Yeah. You have yurt insurance? Yeah. single wall yurt insurance. Anyway, thanks so much for being on the show. We definitely, after we disconnect, we're going to give him your contact information. Bradley, we've known you for a long time. You've been a great supporter of the show, all of our clients. We really appreciate you being on the show.
Yes, and we appreciate how you've supported us personally
during
the moment of truth.
Yeah.
So.
All right.
Well, thank you for having me.
All right. Thank you, Bradley.
All right. Thanks, Bradley. All right. For our listeners out there, you can get a hold of Bradley and his team at 591-8016. Again, that's 591-8016. You can also find out more about Bradley by going to our website, teamlally.com. Check under the resources tab, and he's found under the experts we trust.
All right. So I want to talk about, it's top of mind. It's a real estate show. It's this crazy buyer's market that we're in. What's crazy about it, Adrian?
It's a seller's market.
Well, I mean, I'm sorry.
A seller's market
I'm so thinking of the buyers and all their drama and trauma that they're going through.
You're empathizing with them.
You know what? Instead of saying buyer's market, I should have said the buyers in this market.
The buyers in this market.
Which is a seller's market. What does that mean, seller's market?
That means that there's low inventory and the sellers can...
The sellers control it.
Yes.
They're like the Don Corleone. They're the Don Corleone. Oh, you come to me, you know, and you want to pay lower than the appraised value. I don't think so. So it's like you're putting your offers in front of Don Corleone, and he's like, it's like you almost got to go to him and say, I'm going to make you an offer you cannot refuse.
That's
gonna
right.
appraisal clause. We're gonna go over asking. We're gonna give you on back rub. We're gonna massage your feet if you get into escrow with us. And one of the things we just had an escrow that we opened, and there was about five or six offers. And I will tell you, it was, I'm not saying this was the only thing, but it was part of it.
It was a big part of it.
Okay, you're going to say a big part of it. I'm going to say it was a part of it.
Well, there's multiple parts.
We'll split the difference saying it was a medium part of it.
Okay.
But our reputation as a professional real estate team, we have our own in-house transaction coordinator. She's like a concierge for escrow.
And also, too, the lender, Jody Tonga.
Jody Tonga.
Very strong.
Alicia.
Yes.
Borja, our transaction coordinator.
So just the whole team.
It's like if you're going to the Four Seasons and you're Beyonce and you've been there before, they know your name. They know what kind of food allergies you have, what kind of things your kids like. Mm-hmm. It's like this hotel in Hollywood, California. It's called the Magic Motel.
Okay, we're getting off track.
That's okay. I'm going with something here. You stay with me.
We only have a few minutes left.
They have a phone at the pool, red phone, that the kids can pick up, and it's a popsicle hotline. We're like the popsicle hotline for buyers in this market. You just not going to have one guy standing at the pool with a phone that you can call for a pop. Any canned candy plus popsicles, you can call. The kids, what? I can pick up this phone and I can get any kind of candy? Yes, that's true at this motel. Anyway, our reputation, our transaction coordination, the lender we work with, you need every advantage if you want to be a homeowner in this market the way it is.
And I believe that the buyers also listened to our strategy and advice.
Yes.
And so, I mean, all of those things, I think, together is what helped get into escrow.
We were like that coach for Rocky, you know, and the music was playing. All right. You got to get your pre-approval ready. You got to get your credit all squared away. And we was playing the theme music. He was doing jumping jacks, push-ups, getting everything ready so they can get out there. They were running their miles, and it paid off because when they got in the ring, ding, 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 in this corner, we got the buyer represented by Team Lally going in at 730 credit score. The bell rang. They came out of the corner. Boom. Technical knockout. No, KO right in the first round like a Mike Tyson. Pow. In escrow. You know, I'm joking, but I'm not joking because that is how this market is. You got to be Mike Tyson. You got to be ready to bite Holyfield's ear off. And get,
are you saying no, no, that no, no. we're don't like, be, we
don't
biting?
Be biting the agent. Don't no. bite the listing agent's ear off. I don't know. Maybe you should go to the open house. I'm going to bite your ear if you don't accept my offer. No,
don't
no.
Don't do that.
Don't do a Mike Tyson.
No.
I think he lost his boxing license at that point. It was not good after that. Then he got that face tattoo. What the heck was he thinking? Face tattoo. So if you don't have us help you buy one house, it's going to be like having one face tattoo. It's interesting, but it's a weird first impression, a facial tattoo.
Well, there's also some...
Hey, you know what? There's some nice people with face tattoos. Don't get me wrong. Don't face tattoo people be sending us, hey, what's your problem with the face tattoo?
I've seen some very attractive face tattoos.
Yeah.
In fact, I'm going to get a face tattoo.
Yeah.
On my eyes. I'm going to get some eyeliner done.
We're going to get on face tattoo. It says, accept my offer. That's on dedicated buyer. You put the address of the property you're putting the offer in on your forehead. This is how dedicated I am, committed to your home. But there are at least 15 different strategies that we have that are helping our buyers every week. I would say every week, if not every other week, we're getting a buyer into escrow.
Or more. Yeah.
Yeah. So if you want to find out what those techniques are, what those strategies are, give us a call, 799-9596. And if you're thinking about getting into this market, why not? You know, by the way, we're going to educate you on the process, and we're going to put you in a headlock and choke you out till you buy one house.
No, that's not what we do. And we won't bite your ear off either.
We won't bite your ear off like Mike Tyson with Holyfield. But here's the thing: we're going to tell you. You know what? We may even counsel you and say, hey, maybe now is not the best time to be buying a home based on whatever
your goals and priorities.
Yeah.
Yes. So we've got about 3 minutes left. Did you want to talk about? Yeah, you have all these papers here.
Oh, yeah, so we have OahuDivorce.com is a domain name that leads you to a page on our website. And if you're in family law, you're an attorney, and you're looking for people that can help you resource. How are we a resource for our family law attorneys?
Well, we provide the free continuing law education.
What else?
Well, we can also provide expert testimony.
Yes. Also, if we provide a fair market value, which is the value of a property, because that's a really tough moving target.
Mm-hmm.
That's like...
It moves every day.
That's like trying to take an iPhone away from your 13-year-old daughter. That's a hard target to catch. She's going to fight you for it tooth and nail. So I forgot what I was saying.
About us being resources.
Oh, yeah. Us being resources. Yes. So the title reports, for fair market values. Now I remember. My brain came back.
Good.
Fair market value, we will stand behind those fair market values in court against cross-examination from the opposing party in case they're saying, hey, where'd you come up with this value? We didn't do it on Zillow. We go through a very extensive process to do that. Speaking of which.
On that note, thank you for listening and thank you to our sponsors.
Jody Tanga and Derek Tanga, Pacific Rim Mortgage.
Bradley Maruyama of Allstate Insurance.
Kenji Vendetta, Pillar to Post Home Inspections.
John Speed of Kilauea Pest Control.
Duke Kim Han of Hawaii Pacific Property Management.
Kyle Shimoda of Impact Wealth Solutions.
Wendy Oshiro with Reverse Mortgages Open Mortgage.
Robinson Villavero of Fine Line Paintworks.
James San Diego with Kaji Cleaning. If you want to get a hold of any of our sponsors, just go to teamlally.com. That's Lally.
We also want to give a big thank you to Leah Rodriguez, our producer here in the studio.
Yee-hoo!
Make sure to tune in next week. We'll have an awesome guest talking about something that'll change your life
forever. This is the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the guaranteed
sold program. If we can't sell your home at the agreed upon price in our time frame, we'll have it bought for cash.
Thanks and aloha.
The preceding program was sponsored by Team Lally.